we go, Shane.
Oh, big fish, yeah.
That one?
Fish. Oh, yeah, baby.
Oh, yeah. Oh, that's awesome.
Yeah, on the lizard. Oh, it's a hog, Adam. Hey, everybody, I normally don't start on a show like this, but I'm fishing with my good friend Adam Burish, who you probably know from the Dallas Stars. And it's a day where normally you wouldn't catch this big a fish, Adam. It's a cold front, winds out of the east. I'm going to hoist this puppy up here.
Oh,
I don't
awesome.
Know if I can. Oh, it's a big fish, Adam. But we're fishing smallmouth bass on the Wisconsin River. Oh, he's a hog, Adam. I don't know if I can. You want to lip him?
Did I get the net?
Well, if you can net him or lip him, whatever you'd like to do. But I hate to take a chance because it's a big fish. Right on. Take a look at that, folks.
Wow.
Oh, isn't that a beauty, Adam?
It's the biggest one I've ever seen.
You know, Adam, that's what we're going to catch today, bud. Here, give me knuckles on the
that
first
fish.
That
is awesome.
Like I said, folks, we're fishing the Wisconsin River, and hopefully there's a bunch more of these to go. We're going to just start out here, and we're above Portage, Wisconsin. Once again, I'm with Adam Burish from the Dallas Stars. Stay tuned. We're going to catch a bunch more big smallies. Hey everybody, for live entertainment and great hospitality, Lakeside Bar and Grill is the only place to come on Lake Wisconsin.
I wanted to let you know how much your kind words and your understanding meant to me. You helped me find some peace in the passing of my special friend.
When unconditional love deserves uncompromised care, contact us at Midwest Cremation Service.
Hey, we're Mazinet Marina. 52 years on Lake Mendota, family owned and operated.
Right off M on Bluebill Park Drive South. Follow the signs. If your vehicle has been damaged in an accident, there's only one place to call. That's Poinette Auto Body. Luke and his entire staff will take care of all your auto body needs. Luke and his entire staff, they kept me informed. They used the latest technology. They took care of my claim, and they made sure the whole process went smoothly. So if you're in need of auto body repair, or if you simply just need to replace a vehicle, my friends at Poinette Auto Body and Sales will take care of all your auto body needs. Yeah. Awesome, awesome, awesome.
Maybe I got a habit. I keep my rod here. I want to keep it up a little more.
With which bait?
I got the worm on there. Or the...
Okay. Well, then you throw it down. You put your, you kind of point your rod tip right at your bait.
Okay.
And then you tighten up your line and you raise your rod tip. And if you see your line going to the right or left, wham, you set the hook.
Yep.
Otherwise, if you just feel that, that tap tap, you definitely want your tube to stop at times, be completely motionless on the bottom.
Okay.
Because you know I've seen it where a smallie will come up. And he'll look at that bait and he'll turn his head and he'll kind of eye it. And he's wondering if he should eat it, and then he picks it up. So they'll usually hit that when it's motionless. That's when you'll get your hit. So most of the time when I first throw out, I let it just sink. I put my rod tip down. I go for a 5-second break. Then I reel up my slack and just feel for that weight.
Yep.
And if you feel that weight right away, and a little tug, boom, hit him hard. Yeah, well, that didn't take you long, bud.
No. Nope.
Is it a good one?
You put me in a good spot.
Another beautiful river smallie.
I just hoist them right up here?
Yeah, just bring them on up. Usually leave a little bit more line out next time. That way it's easier for you to grab them because you got a really, you got an 8.5-foot rod there. But that's not a bad, now that's not male. You know, the one I got was a female.
Yep.
And you'll have both male and female guarding the nest today. A lot of times what'll happen, you'll catch the little male first, and then the
This
female.
One's a female?
That's a male.
Oh, that's a male.
Yeah, skinnier belly and just smaller. Usually the boys in the fish world are smaller.
All right. Not in the real world.
Nope.
Well, it's not as big as Bill's, but I'll take it.
Yeah, well, 1-1.
Yeah, 1-1.
We'll keep that going even all day and have a fun day.
That's fun.
I got the mama, you got the daddy. So how'd that hit? Tap-tap?
Yeah,
or did you
tap,
just feel
tap,
the weight?
And I
you
just
did?
Reeled it up, and just like you said, the line started kind of moving off to the side, and then I just cranked on it.
You betcha. That's the way you gotta do it.
Got my legs into it like I usually do. And
yeah, you betcha.
I only got 60 degree water up here. I just can't believe this water this year just is not warming up. Fish on?
Fish on.
Ooh, good one. He's looking pretty good. Take it easy with him. It might be a really big one. Good job, Adam. It's a nice smallie, isn't
yeah.
it? Was he up pretty tight?
Yep, right when it hit, too.
Oh, nice big fish. Should I get the net for you?
Yeah, sure.
All right, I'll come back. It looks like a good fish.
Oh, yeah. Oh, that's awesome.
Yeah, that's a big fish. I can probably lip him right here. Oh, I better not lose another one for you. I'm gonna know. It's a hog. Let me get the hook out for you real quick. Whoa, it is a moose. Take a look. Oh, it's a big, heavy fish, Adam. Let's get the hook out of there real quick. Now, it's got two hooks. Yeah, just there you go. Perfect. Here, grab your fish. Show everybody at home what you can get on the beautiful Wisconsin River.
Wow.
Isn't that a beautiful fish? You want your picture taken
That's
with
awesome.
It, too?
Yeah.
Cool. That is a nice fish. Wow. Well, it's cold, but sure does warm you up when you catch a fish like that.
Yeah.
Unbelievable. There, well, it snapped a few. Yeah. I think it took quite a few. All right.
Perfect.
Cool. Well, we'll let That's that one cool. go. And
2-1, Bill.
Ah, I got to catch up. Cool. What a nice fish. Good job. Knuckles on that.
That's
big
awesome.
Ones when they're 18 inches. Yeah.
So now Whew. I wondered.
That's a good fish.
He probably just threw it right on him, on his bed there. Or
Real close.
Huh?
Yeah. And he just reacted. You know, they're in that defensive mode where they don't want anything near their bed.
Yep.
And that thing came swimming by and he just came up and wham. You know?
So it may not matter even if it's a spinnerbait or a worm.
You know?
It's just if you hit it in the spots.
You get in their
at,
spot where they
it.
Yeah, they're gonna eat it. So wow, good job, man.
That's cool.
That was a good fish.
Yeah, that was fun.
So that's the biggest smallie you got so far?
Biggest smallie I've ever caught.
Sweet.
Yep.
Well, let's go get about five more real quick. Ooh, 2-1. Pressure's on the kid. There he is. Oh, you son of a gun. There's a whole bunch of them up there, Adam. This guy was swimming to the right. Throw right up towards that log on shore, that little log. There's a bunch of smallies up there. Come on, Adam.
Yep.
You son of a gun. That's 2-3-1. Oh, that's another big one. Did you get off?
Got him. I got him.
Oh, he's off. I'm kidding you. I'll lip him for you. What am I, the netter and the lipper today? What the heck's going on here? Right over here. Looked like another big quality fish. Come here, Mr. Smallie. Where are you, bud? Oh, simmer down. Oh man, that's a tough jaw. Oh, look at that. Now this is Adam's fish, but I'm holding it. Another beaut, huh?
Yeah.
Look at that pudgy little smallie. It's a good feeling fish. Nice.
Those are fun to catch.
Yeah, and you see where the tube is, folks? Beautiful hook set right in the side. Just nice.
I learned from the master.
There you go. Boy, what a pretty fish. Not a mark on him. Boy. Well, let's go catch some more. Good job, Adam. We'll let him get back in there and get to his business. Go make some more smallies for us, big guy. Yeah, see ya. Woohoo, that's fun. Wonder if that's the same guy that showed himself. Oh, it's a big fish, isn't it? Here, I didn't think it was that big, Adam. I threw out. Oh, it's a hog. Oh, it's a really big fish. Oh, Lordy. I'll come down there really quick, unless you want to lip him.
I can maybe get him.
Guy's a big fish. You can probably lift him right in. You got pretty heavy line. Oh, nice. Watch out for the hook, bud.
Yeah.
Good fish. Another. You are putting it to me, Adam. Cool. We saw him a few times. Look at that. That's 18 inches.
Yeah, that's cool.
That's a beaut. Look at the size of him. Oh, the sperm's coming out of him right there. That's a sure sign he's spawning. You know, that's a male fish, Adam.
Is it?
It's not a female, yeah, because he's what's coming out, is doing his deal.
That's cool.
Wow, let's catch the female to him. Woo, that'd be a big fish, really big. Yeah, he might have been spawning up there. That's why we saw him cruising around. I don't know. Boy, that's a nice one. For being a male, oh my goodness, that's a big fish. bought my, look at that, I'm at him. Big fish. Oh, you're on him. This is going to be good. I'm going to get up there too, just in case there's a male and female swimming. I'm going to go to the right a little bit, but we should catch this fish. Must have a bed up there. It's working. You're going to catch that fish right there. Come on, big boy. Where is he? Oh, I got him.
Oh, and I got him at him. Yeah. Nice fish, baby.
Oh, it came off. It was a hog. It was a hog.
Ah. Golly.
Maybe you'll get. You know, a lot of tournament fishermen down south, especially, they'll catch the male off of a nest.
Yeah.
You know, and then they'll put it in their live well. And then, because that nest isn't being guarded anymore, the female will come out from the deeper water and guard the nest. Then they'll catch the female.
Oh,
and then
cool.
Keep the female.
Yep.
And they throw the male back in. Yep.
Fish on.
Oh, are you kidding me? Oh, it's a big one.
That's the same spot I caught the last one.
No kidding. I think they're all big at them. Oh, that's a really big smallie. You want help, or are you going to get her?
I'll try and get it.
All right. Oh, it's a hog.
Oh, it's a fat one.
Look at the size of that smallie. I think it just shook your tube. Oh. People at home are not going to believe the size of the smallies we're catching on the Wisconsin River. You should be able to just pull that line right up real quick. Just hoist. Woof. Oh, hoo! That's a big one, Adam. Oh, show the people at home that big
one.
Belly. Look at that. That's 19 inches, Adam. That is just a hog of a bass.
Wow, is that big. I can feel
huge.
The weight on that thing.
That's huge.
That was awesome.
That's got to be 4 pounds. Yeah, hold that pup up. I'll get a picture of it with you.
I'll just snap one.
You sure?
Yeah.
What do you got there? 18? 18 and a quarter? Or is that 18? Yep. 18 incher.
18. Cool.
Oh, good job, Adam. That's a big fish. Let that big boy go real quick. Wow. Big, big fish. My tube got all messed up too. Well, Adam, what do you think of these smallmouth bass?
That's unbelievable.
In the Wisconsin
That's
River?
So much fun.
Jeez, they're big, aren't they?
Well, it's cool because when you can feel them kind of like tap, 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 and your rod almost shakes, and you can crank as hard as you want on it, and then you got it.
Yeah.
It's cool. Yeah. It's not like any other kind of fish where you kind of feel it hit, and you just reel it in. This one, you feel it whack, whack,
yeah.
Whack, whack, whack. And
it's yeah, they're sucking it in. Yeah.
That's fun.
It is a fun thing to do.
Big, fat one.
I didn't realize how big that fish was until he got in the boat. It just doesn't get any. It just doesn't get old, Adam. Woo! Oh, it's not as big as yours, but it's a smallie. Whoa! Boy, they're fighting, aren't they?
Yeah, they're fun.
These guys are just angry. Oh, he's not nearly what you just caught. He's a keeper, but he's nothing like. Oh, he's just digging, digging, digging. Oh, I love smallmouth bass. Come here, baby. Woohoo! Look at that baby compared to yours. But still,
cool?
What a big, beautiful fish, folks. You know? I mean, this is still a nice quality keeper bass. So that's 7, 5-2. I got some fishing to do to catch up to Adam here, folks, but I'm going to get her done. A few words from our sponsors. We'll be right back to see how the second half of the day goes. Let's get him unhooked.
There we go. This is fun.
Took a little bit. Kiss that baby bye. Go get your mama. Baloop. Man, they're slamming in here.
Yeah.
The death of a pet is never easy for pet parents, but comforting surroundings and the attention to your needs is important to Midwest Cremation Service. Whether you choose to be a part of the process or not, Midwest Cremation Service is there for you during this time of loss.
Come on. Oh my goodness. Hey everybody, Bill Spahn here to remind you that it's a good thing to practice catch and release. Good for you, good for others, and good for her, and especially good for them. Remember to let them go. I'm Bill Spahn saying thanks for watching Fishing Wisconsin TV, keeping it real.
Hey everybody, for live entertainment and great hospitality, Lakeside Bar and Grill is the only place to come on Lake Wisconsin.
Hey folks, I'm Will Bradison, co-host of Fishing Wisconsin TV. When I'm not out catching fish with Bill Spahn, I'm selling real estate for Century 21. Whether you're looking right here in South Central Wisconsin, across state lines, or even across the country to buy, sell, or build, give me a call, I can help. I can be reached at 608-345-6090. My email is will, W-I-L-L, at c21affiliated.com.
Bring your whole family to the Midwest's largest fishing expo. All the latest in fishing technology, tackle, baits, boats, poles, and reels. Plan your next fishing adventure. Attend one of our many seminars and meet the pros. There's something for the whole family. The last weekend in February at the Alliant Energy Center just off the Beltline on John Nolan Drive. For more information, visit our website or give us a call at 608-245-1040. See you there.
Beautiful. Wow, is that cool?
Oh, yeah.
That one. Adam stands up before he drills him.
That was the exact same spot you threw yours.
Ooh, it looks good. Maybe you got the mama. Isn't that something? One after another. Just one after another. They look like twins. Oh, yours might be a little bigger. Oh, yours is a nice fish. No doubt about it. Nice fish. Nothing wrong with that.
That's fun.
You know, last time out, Adam, that fish there was the biggest fish we caught all day. Remember? Down by Portage.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Yep. That would have been the biggest fish of the day. Now it's the smallest fish of the day.
Yeah.
Yeah. Still nice.
Wow. This is awesome.
Cool. Yeah, this is fun. Cool, cool, cool deal.
I threw mine exactly where yours went, and there must be a couple in there.
Yeah. Oh, I bet. Once you find the beds, it's gold.
Yeah.
It is. Yeah. We'll get them. Around it, because a lot of times a smallmouth will build a bed right next to a log because they don't have so much area to protect them. So as we're drifting down the river here, just get your bait right up on it and be ready, because it's a prime spot to fish.
All right.
And be ready, because it's a prime spot to fish.
All right. All right, we'll see.
Catch him. Oh, are you kidding me? So that was a bet I saw.
Yeah.
Was he after yours?
Yep.
All right, well, get in there and get him. Oh, that was cool. It's like your eyes just don't... Oh, come on.
Yep.
Are you kidding me? We just got here, Adam. Adam, you've been tearing me up. I'm out of the game. Good one?
I think so.
You're killing me. Oh, another good fish, Adam. Aren't they so pretty? They're so pretty. Here I am, folks, out of the game. I'm out here, Adam. I'm up here retying my knot, and Adam's pulling in 3-pound smallmouth. I guess I should have kept you out in the middle of the river for a while, Adam.
That was my first cast since we got back here.
Are you kidding? Oh. Well, we came back to the spot, folks. We left it for a while, decided to come on back where we had the most luck, and look at what his first cast produces. Isn't that something?
Another pretty nice one.
Nice, yeah, real nice. Nice keeper smallmouth. Good job, bud.
Thanks.
Your fish are bigger than mine today.
I don't think so.
He's jumping full. Look at this guy go. He doesn't want to quit. Don't you love it? Oh, he's so pretty. Got him hooked right in the top. Well, you're coming in the boat, buddy. Oh, yeah. Another one. You got one going?
Yep.
I thought you were going to have a double. Oh, ouch. You always crouch down when you're gonna set that hook. But I'll just get us in closer. Can't get there with it. But I'm thinking they see a lizard down by their nest. They're gonna hit it. Even that frog to throw in. I might even do that. If I don't get a hit here, I'm gonna... Oops. Spoke too soon. Oh,
nice.
Yeah, baby.
Nice. First cast right here.
First cast. Here I tell Adam to throw a lizard, folks, and look what I did to him. Although, you know, it's Adam's got me down by four, so now it's three, Adam. I'm catching up quick. I feel like it's a third period comeback, buddy.
I'm getting nervous already.
He's a little guy, but you know what? It counts. Pretty little fish.
Yeah, it is pretty fish.
Yeah. I love these smallies. And he inhaled it, so that's a good sign. This is a small male protecting the nest. Oh, it's going to take
There we go. Whew.
Didn't have to hurt him too much. No, he's fine, actually. Little tiny male bass, but cute little guy. We'll let him get back. His tail's not, I don't even think he started the spawn process. His tail looks in good shape. Let that little guy get back to what he wants to do. Cool. So Adam, you know, you got your start in professional hockey with the Chicago Blackhawks, and you're with those guys 4 years, right?
Yep.
And then you got a Stanley Cup, which is one of the coolest things ever. But then you went to the Dallas Stars. How was that for, you know, was that a big change, switching to another pro team?
Yeah, it's different when you play with the same guys for 4 or 5 years and they kind of become your best buddies. You spend more time with them than you do with anybody, so you get comfortable with those guys, you get comfortable with the city, and then all of a sudden you got to pick up and move, and that's different. But it was, for me, it was fun. It was a fun change. I got to go to some warm weather here. I'm 60 degrees out and this is freezing. This is like winter weather in Dallas, so
I suppose
the weather was great there. I got to always be, you know, shorts and a t-shirt every day, and the weather was great and the team was good. We were, for 50 games, we were first place in the league, and then a bunch of injuries hit us, but it was a fun change for me. It was, I liked it in Dallas. I loved the weather there. I loved the team there. I loved the city, so it was good, but it's definitely different than Chicago. Anytime you win a championship and in a city and with a certain bunch of guys, you just have that instant bond. You know, you have that lifelong friendship then, just because you did something special together. And so I still miss those guys, but we keep in touch, and I still get back to Chicago and have a little fun there.
So what was it like when the Stars played the Blackhawks?
My first time back to Chicago, it was uncomfortable. It was weird. Here's some of your best buddies in hockey, and now you got to go and play against them. I got to go and try and hit them. I got to go and try and rough them up. So the first time it was a little uncomfortable. I wanted to joke around and have fun with them, but you got to be careful that, you know, to your teammates, you're not making it look like, you know, you're trying to be buddy-buddy out there, so you still have a job to do. And so the first time was awkward. The second time, third time, and fourth time we played, it was on. It was fun. It was no friends out there. I was trying to hit him, and I was trying to get the last laugh on him. We beat him the last three times we played him, so woo-hoo! I got the last laugh.
I guess you did. Yeah. Good job. You were kind of bringing it in slow, weren't you?
He just followed it.
He ate it as you're bringing it in slow. Oh, that's a big fish, Adam. There you go. You can hoist him right into you. Well, he swallowed it down even. Hit it good. Do you want me to net him?
I think I can just swim in here.
He's a pretty good one. Look at that. Another big fish. I got your pole for you, bud.
Yeah, he swallowed that thing.
He did. And he ate it as it was kind of coming in, didn't he? I got it. That's a real good fish.
Yeah, he kind of followed me in there. He was hungry. That's it.
There you go. Good job. And that guy followed your bait.
He followed in. I was halfway to the boat.
He just nailed it.
And then he nailed it, yeah.
That usually doesn't happen with tubes, but I guess it can. Good job. Nice health. You're getting some big chubby fish today. Yeah. You're killing me.
A little one, I think.
Is he? You are just on them today. I can't believe it. It's like every third cast you're pulling in a smallie. A little bit smaller, but still a nice fish. That would have been the biggest one on our first trip. Yeah. Remember?
Yeah.
But we caught a ton of them. That's another good fish. So Adam, what do you think of smallies up here in the Wisconsin River?
This is awesome. This is fun. Well, you put me in such good spots here. You know where they are, and I just got to throw this thing out there. And they just slam it. It's a fun fish to catch because, like you said, you can feel it like tap, 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 and then you just crank on it and pull it in. And
as soon as you set the hook, you kind of know how big it is.
Yeah,
you know.
Like this one, I could tell now it's smaller. It was a little bit smaller, but it's just cool when you feel that wham, 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 tap, 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 and then you slam it.
Yeah, it is. It's a great fish to catch. Oh yeah. He's nice. A little feller, I think. But I got this big rod I'm using. Maybe, he's not too bad. I love it. Smallmouth bass and the Wisconsin River. The only thing that'd make me more happier is if they'd deliver us a pizza out in the boat. Oh, he's not so bad.
Nice. Oh, nice.
Come here, buddy. Come to Papa. Nice little smallie with me.
Oh, just
and
missed
I just
mine too.
Couldn't figure it out. It was the strangest bite at him. He'd come with.
Oh, this guy came back at me twice too.
Well, get him quick and we'll have a double. Mine's a big fish at him.
Oh,
this
wow.
is a really big smallie. Look at that.
Oh.
Oh, that's catch and release at the boat. That guy
that
was
a monster.
20. He
yeah.
was close to 20. That's the biggest one of the day so far.
That was a monster.
Oh boy, was that a fish.
They're in there.
Oh, that was a pretty fish.
He almost had a double. That was a monster.
Oh, did you see his
mouth? That was the biggest one I've Woo. Seen yet.
As a single mother of two children with autism, I understand the challenges, the heartaches, and the expense in obtaining proper therapy equipment. That is why I started Affordable Therapy Solutions, to give you all the tools you need at a low, affordable cost.
Amanda and her staff at Affordable Therapy Solutions come through for us every time.
Visit affordabletherapysolutions.com and discover all the wonderful treatment options for your loved ones.
Hey everybody, for live entertainment and great hospitality, Lakeside Bar and Grill is the only place to come on Lake Wisconsin.
Well, Adam, what a day on the river, huh?
I'd say.
Those big, beautiful smallies, you know, there's nothing more fun than catching those big smallmouth when they're on their beds or right before they're spawning. And you know, the old tubes came through again today. You know, they look like a little crayfish. We caught a bunch of fish just above portage on the Wisconsin River. Can't thank you enough for joining me in the boat. It's always fun when you come fishing with me, Adam. And hey, folks, thanks for tuning in. I hope you learned a little something about pre-spawn bass today and bass on the beds. Till next week, this is Adam Burish with Bill Spahn. Keep it safe on the water and always keeping it real.